Along to another video from Gundog and Fly. The magic of the dry fly, what is it? Well, for me, well, I like to fish all methods of fly fishing. I like nymph fishing. I fish Euro nymphing styles, and my preferred Euro nymphing or preferred nymphing style is the upstream nymph. And occasionally I'll fish wet flies, but over and above everything else, I'll fish the dry fly given the choice. And people often ask me why that's the case, when there are times when I probably catch more fish using other methods and I'd still choose to fish the dry fly. And for me, it's like when a wild trout, wild spooky trout generally, comes up and takes your fly off the surface. It's like a vindication of everything you've worked at up to that point in that circumstance. You figured out how to get that fly to the trout so that he's convinced that it's a natural fly and he comes up and takes it. And it's a vindication of the strategies and the tactics you've used, and not only that, your flies as well. And every circumstance and every trout is different. So you have to tailor the strategy and the tactics for that individual fish. And when the fish comes up and takes your fly, it's just like, that's the magic for me. It's a vindication of everything that I do. And I don't get it right all the time. Nobody does. And you'll see throughout this video where I get it right a lot of the time. And then there are times where I don't get it right. And that's the challenge. That's the challenge that keeps me coming back. If I fail to catch a trout for a particular reason, I'll try and figure that out and work on it. And the next time then hopefully catch him. So that's the magic of the dry fly for me. And I hope you enjoy the video. And if you liked the video, hit the like button and consider subscribing for future videos. I make videos like this all the time about fly fishing, gun dog training, hunting, shooting, all that sort of stuff. So if you're into all that kind of thing, hit the subscribe button and you'll be notified, and hit the notification bell and you'll be notified of any future videos. So thanks once again for joining me, and here's Dry Fly Magic. Late June, gotta love the month of June. The river, as you can see, is very low, a lot of weed growth, and it's my favorite time of the year for fishing. I love when the river is low. That's when I catch the most of my trout and catch big ones too. So last video you saw the LL, Sage LL. It's 7'9", 3 weight. And I got such a response to the last video, I thought I have to do a bit more with this rod just to show you how good it actually is. The accuracy and the delicacy. And I'm fishing here size 18 Sherry Spinner. Late evening, it's approximately 9 o'clock, late June. And I'm hoping for a bit of a night rise or an evening rise. And be sure to stay with me and see how this little noodle rod performs. Millions of spinners.
Absolutely millions of them.
The deep water here. There's a fish rising downstream of me here. He's probably going to stop now, being as I've come in above him. Oh no, he's only a small fish, so we'll leave him alone. I don't know whether you can see this, the amount of spinners that are on the water. So I'm having to compete with those. Incredible amount of flies, literally thousands.
probably millions. In any case, I've no choice but to compete with them and hope that the trout find my fly is more favourable. Now we've got a few trout moving up here ahead. And as you can see, what happens sometimes, they gather in a sort of pod. And there's a bunch of trout together here. And they're really on the feed, on the spinners. So, let's see if they like my one. Now, I don't think any of them are particularly big fish. He found it favourable. He preferred it to all the naturals. It says something for my Sherry Spinner. My version is a Sherry Spinner. We've got millions of naturals now. Oh, I think now when I let him go, he swam, no, thought he might have swam up the way to these fish and scared them off. Oh, I thought that was my fly. Yes. Isn't it amazing the way they'll take my fly, which is made of metal and feathers essentially, and they'll leave off what are thousands of natural flies. So now, that's them caught. Oh, there's one more further up. Didn't rise, he only rose once, in spite of all the flies that are underwater. There he is. There's actually two of them. Just stopped for some unknown reason. One of them's back. There are literally millions of spinners coming down now, and the trout are very quiet. I'm going to put the camera down to the level of the water and hope that you'll be able to see the amount of flies that are actually coming down the river. It's just incredible. Literally millions. They're coming on in bunches, look. So, not easy to compete with them. Now just down here, there's a trout rising and there's another one just outside him. Now when the river is low like this, gin clear, it's extremely difficult to get close enough without them detecting you. So I'm going to make an effort to try and sneak in along here and wait for a moment and hope that they'll continue to rise. So a low profile. May have detected me already, but we won't know now for a moment. Now even when you get, oh there he is again, even when you get into a position like this, there's no guarantee you're going to catch the fish, because any little mistake or they will detect it immediately. These are wild fish and they detect anything out of the ordinary immediately and will stop rising. So even every move on the bank has to be really quiet. So now we'll give them a moment again and see will they rise. There's one there and there's another just out here. I'm definitely close enough to cast to them, but we'll see, did they detect me? There he is. And I think he's taking a Canis fly. But the rise form, it looks like a Canis fly. And that is a fly in the region of size 30, I think. Almost impossible to copy. But I'm fishing my Sherry Spinner. This guy has detected me. I'm not sure about the one outside. I'll try the one outside. Drag. This guy's come back again. Try the one outside again, just. Not easy to catch these. When the river's this low and clear, they have all the time to see and detect things. Particularly, they can see the leader, they can scrutinize the fly, and anything that looks any way odd to them, they'll just stop rising. So now I think the two of them have gone down, so this just goes to show you, no matter how careful your approach, no matter how delicate your casting might be, you can still fail miserably, just as I've done with these two here. Yeah, they're gone down, that's the end of that. Oh yeah, get here. massively strong. Let's try and keep him out of the boat. Whoa! This fella's a really big fish. He's trying to get in the bulrushes here beside me. Yeah. Got him out again. This is a big fish. Get him to the net, it would be good. Whoa. Off he goes again. Blinded by the bit of weed around his eyes. Oh, difficult task. Here we go, come on, fella. Yeah! What a fish. What a fish. Unreal. Get the fly out. Wow, surprising what you can catch with a size 18 fly. Now, see if we can get a look at him. Wow, it's a bit dark, but what a fish, a real beauty. Probably in the 3 pounds range. Here we go, fella. Back he goes. Ooh. Adrenaline rush. Fish now, Mick, I'd say. Going to the weeds, is he? Yeah. You want to turn him? Turn him back down the river. No, you bring your rod around you at that side. Lively, isn't he? Mm. Plenty of fighting him. He's gone down under the weeds, me. You need to bring strain down that way, Tom. Just down that way, you need to bring it.
Eh? The
just trapped inside in that choke, sure, whatever that choke is.
What?
Just trapped inside in there.
Where?
No, look, just gone around that choke there, look. Bring him up here, I need him.
Mother of Jesus. Didn't throw it, didn't you?
Hold that rod there. Oh. You get the fly out first.
Get a force on the rod.
Fish is putting in a serious run. Pretty big fish, I think. Ooh. A lot of fighting him. Oh, what a fish, he's a beauty. Oh yeah, what a lump. Fly out first. Yeah. What a great fish. Put up a powerful fight. He deserves to fight another day. Nothing wrong with him. Oh, fella. Whoa. Yeah. Lovely fish.
He's a small lad. Just that went right over. Isn't it?
Team coming for a look. It's the leader that's giving the game away, actually.
The leader has given it away. What have you on? Is it like fishing rope? That was fair accurate cast. Oh, yeah. Not bad fish. Nothing wrong with him, though. Never let a big lighter to catch him. We're looking at them and we're saying they're midgets. If another leg got there, he'd be having a hog. Huh? There's nothing wrong with him.
That big bunch of bulrushes there, out in the river, there's a trout rising in front of that. He's rose three or four times. And in order to fish him, I won't be able to fish him off the bank because of that high grass. And even if the high grass wasn't there, fishing off the high bank would probably cause a drag. So what I have to do is I have to get right down in here and try and sneak up behind him. So here goes. And it's quite deep down there too, I think. But I've no alternative but to get in here if I want to try and fish these trout. I think there might even be more than one. This grass. plastic, everything gets stuck when you're trying to get in the river. Right. Try and get in without making any noise. That will alert them. I don't know whether they've figured me out already. Sometimes what can happen is you get in the river, you frighten the fish that's just here. They go up along and frighten the rest. So just have to wait here a minute and see if he rises again. Oh yeah, there he is. Now, plenty of grass, bulrushes and all the rest of it. I think he's a big fish, but it's a fish. Well, that's a long ways behind him, so. How did I miss him? What happened? He came up and took it. I struck and didn't connect. Oh well, so much for all the effort. And once that happens, they're gone down. They won't rise again for a while. Oh well. Fish out there, so I'm going to make the effort to get out to him. Looks like a good fish, alright. There's one actually nearer here as well. The small one out of the way so we can catch the bigger one. Oh yes. Oh, gone. Got a run out of him anyway. Gone with the fly, brought me. He brought me as well.
Oh,
he was, yeah, he's a big fish. Fish out here now. Here, Mick, look at this. Come up here. Yeah, get the fly out of him. Yeah, I know, yeah. Great fish. Oh yeah. Beautiful. Stunner. Okay, fella. Come out of here. This is a big fish now. This is a really big fish. Oh, he got off. Shit. Ah. Oh. Bro. There's another fish out here now. This is a long cast for this little rod. Yes. Not as big as the last one, I'd say, but try and get him on the reel. All good fishes at the same time. Ooh. very awkward position. Try knitting. Almost impossible position here. If I can bring him down another bit. I can't even see him now. Oh yeah, he's a big fish. He's a big fish, all right. Right, fella, let's see if we can get you in here. Oh, I missed him. Yeah, got him. Wow, that was some battle. Sage LL, well able to handle them. Wow, he's a serious fish. Let's see where my fly is. I think the fly may have fallen out of him. Oh no, it's not, still in him. Get up here. Fly out. Well, whoop. Safely away anyway, jumped out of my hands. That was good. Whew. All the excitement. It's quite deep here as well now. Maybe there's a pathway through here. Oh. Things I do to catch fish. Oh, the bulrushes again. Bulrushes are a torment. Whoa, and into the bulrushes again. Yep. fish.